For producing large value of the impulse current, a number of the capacitors are charged and discharges into the circuit in a parallel manner. The arrangement which is shown here, that's in the thimble charging and discharging, which is done in the parallel into the circuit. In order to minimize the value of the effective inductance of the capacitors will be divided to smaller units. If there are n1 number of the group of the capacitors, then each consisting of n2 units, then L0 is the inductance of the common discharge path, then L1 is that of the in each group and L2 is that of the each unit. Then the effective inductance L is given as L is equal to L0 plus L1 by N1 plus L2 divided by M1 into N2. So the arrangement of the capacitor, which is done in the harsh or shape layout to minimize the value of the load inductance. So the essential the part which is required for the impulse generator are the first one, a DC charging unit giving a variable voltage to the capacitor bank, means which is the input which is required for the charging of the capacitor. Then the capacitor generally is of 0.5 to 5 microfarad, each with a low inductance value, should be capable to give high short circuit current. Then which is required is an additional air cored inductor of high current values, and there must be proper shunts and oscillograph for the measurement purpose, because these are working at there is a potential difference from high voltage to the low voltage end. Then a triggering unit and the spark gap for the initiation of the current generators. So these are the essential part which is required for the impulse current generation. Next we have generation of rectangular current pulses. So these, the rectangular current pulses for high magnitude can be done by discharging a pulse network or the cable which is charged previously. So the basic circuit for generation of rectangular current pulses, which is given here, that the length of the cable or equivalent pulse forming network which is charged to some specified value, like with the help of the DC supply, when there is an spark gap is short circuited, the previously charged cable or the pulse network will supply the energy to the test object. So this is the basic circuit which we have for this generation. Then it is very difficult to get that coaxial cable of a sufficient capacitance and the length, so that we are going for some artificial transmission lines with a lumped value of the inductance and the capacitance. Generally, it is 6 to 9 LC sections, which is sufficient to get that the good rectangular waves. So these are the two waveforms which we can get by these two circuits. That is nothing but the first one is by using the pulse form network. Second one is by using a coaxial cables. So to produce that rectangular pulse, a coaxial cable which having the impedance which is given as Z0 is equal to root of L0 by C0 value, where L0 and C0 value inductance and the capacitance per unit length which is used. And also we know that the cable which is charged to the particular value with the help of the voltage is nothing but V. And this is the R value, the resistance of the test object which is required to test the device. Then the current pulses I is given as that we know that Ohm's law, I is equal to V by R. So here there is a total impedance, means impedance of the cable plus the impedance of the test object, means it is a resistance. So that's what we know. It is very difficult to get that coaxial cable of sufficient capacitance and the length, so we'll go for an some artificial transmission line. So if we are using that, then the duration of the pulse time will become t is equal to 2 into n minus 1 into root of lc. So where n is nothing but the number of the sections which is used, and the L and C values are capacitance and inductance per stage are the per sections. So this is what, then that's what we know. It is usually 6 to 9 LC section is sufficient to give a good rectangular waves. Next we have tripping and control of impulse generators. So in large impulse generators, the spear gaps generally which are used for the spark gap arrangement, apart from that the gaps which are formed by hemispherical electrodes. So these are the gaps arranged in such a manner that the sparking gap or sparking of one gap resulting in automatic sparking of another gap whenever there is a voltage which is impressed on the other. So in order to get that consistency in the sparking, irradiation from an UV light which is provided from the bottom of all the spark gaps. So to make it that trip the generate at a particular predetermined time, the spark gaps may be mounted on a movable frame. By reducing the distance by the moving electrode which is closer to the other electrode, so there is a possibility of the conduction may take place between those two. It is a very difficult and does not assurance any consistency in the controlling. So that the simple method for controlling, which is given as with the help of the three electrode gap arrangement, which you can see to that, the generator which is fitted with the DC supply, means the charging unit having the three electrode gap arrangement. So this third electrode which is kept between the top and the bottom electrode, so there is a maintaining of the potential with help of the R1 and the R1. With help of these resistance, this could be able to maintain some potential between the top electrode and the bottom electrode. So when there is a tripping signal which is initiated by the pulse which is given by the thyristor G by closing the switch S. So when it is closing the switch, the capacitor the C will produces an exponentially decaying pulse of positive polarity. So this will goes to the sweeping circuit and initiates an oscilloscope time base. So when the thyristor conducts by receiving a pulse from the switch S and produces a negative pulse with the help of the capacitance C1 at the central electrode of the three electrode gap arrangement. Hence the voltage between the central electrode and the top electrode of the three electrode gap arrangement, which is above its sparking potential. So hence there is the conduction will take place, means this will initiate, there is a formation of the sparking between these two electrodes, means it is artificially which is inducted with the help of the third electrode. So R2 will make sure that there is a decoupling of the voltage oscillation which is produced at the spark gaps, which is entering the oscilloscope through the common trip circuit. So this three electrode gap arrangement which is requires a large space and elaborate construction, so that nowadays we are going with some other method, that is nothing but the trichotron gap arrangement. The drawback of the three electrode gap arrangement can be eliminated with the help of the trichotron gap arrangement. So here there are the two electrodes, one is subjected to the high voltage electrode, another one is the earth electrode. In that earth electrode there is a trigger electrode which is a metal rod structure, and there is an annular gap between the trigger electrode and the earth electrode is of 1 mm. The when the voltage is supplied to the trigger electrode because of the space charge, so there is a field distortion across the earth electrode and the high voltage electrode may takes places, resulting in the conduction and the breakdown may takes places to the particular devices. It is a very compact device and which is requires the very very small amount of the voltage for the conduction between the two electrode. And this is a polarity sensitive, and a proper polarity pulse should be applied for the correct operation.